What's shaking YouTube, Biggie here. You can see behind me, I've got two motorized bicycles. I just recently finished doing a whole lot of stuff to this particular bike here, my Bad Omen bike, which is the red one. I swapped out the bars, the grips, did a whole bunch of other modifications to it.
But what we're going to be doing today to the red bike is the same thing I did to this here Ratfink bike. I'm going to show you the procedure on how to remove this part, clean it, prep it, engine turn it, and then paint your graphic on it. Get yourself a flathead screwdriver.
Now the thing is, when you put the clutch cover back on, you don't want to over tighten it. There is a gasket, but there really isn't a lot of oil or anything that can get out of the clutch cover. It's just to keep dust and whatnot out of there. So we're going to take our carb cleaner, give it a good spritz, take our rag, wipe the grease off. And I got a little smudge on the outside, so I'm going to give it another spray. Take a clean part of my rag and wipe her down.
And that's your first step. Nice clean clutch cover.
Next part in this is to prep the surface for the engine turning. You're going to use some 120 grit paper, which I know this is a sanding disc, but it'll do the job. That's just to knock it down. And to smooth it out a bit, we're going to use some 1000 grit. You're going to take your 120, assuming it's wet dry paper, give it a little dip in some water to act as a lubricant, and just start lightly sanding the surface. You're going to sand this surface until it starts to look shiny as opposed to rough. You just got to get it smooth enough by hand that the turning will take to it. And always sand in one direction, linear, front to back, along the teardrop shape like this. This is wet dry automotive body sandpaper, and we're going to go over it with the 1000 grit now. Before, right, it's all satin finish, like that. Rough casting, nice and shiny. I'm going to be using Meguiar's NXT all metal polish. It works on all metals and it does a really nice job. So I'm just going to apply a little bit on my rag here, and we're going to wipe it into the surface and rub the hell out of it. Oh, look at that. It's like a mirror now. First, we're going to take our Stabilo pencil, which is it's a watercolor pencil. We use these in pinstriping a lot when we lay out line work, and trust me, I'm going to be using it later after I finish this procedure. But what we're going to want to do is engine turn this, so we're going to need guide marks. And what you're going to want to do is you want to rule out lines that are about as thick as your thumb. So we're going to start at the top. Not where the bolt hole is, but the actual top of the case. And I'm going to put my thumb there just to roughly gauge. And I'm going to take my Stabilo pencil and make a light line. Put my thumb down again. And we're going to mark another line. You're going to take a piece of cloth, and you're going to take a piece of this sandpaper. We'll try the 120 grit first, and what we're going to do is we're going to take this 120 grit, and we're going to twist this 120 grit paper, this wet stuff, around the end of a cloth. Is you're going to use your guidelines for placing them. So we're going to use this one here first. I'm going to put it. You give it a twist, and then what you're going to want to do is you take that same bud and you overlap about halfway, give it a twist, then you go over again, overlap, give her a twist, and you keep doing that. I'm going to do the previous line here. What you're going to want to do is each twist on the next line is going to be between two twisted circles. So let's go here. I'll just kind of half twist it there.
and we're going to go here to the next line, midway between the two circles, and give it a twist. Midway between the circles, and remember to overlap your previous one. Give it a twist. Down in the alley behind Louis Bar, the Stranglers and the Philo play out the bazaar.
Nice close-up view of my freshly engine turned surface. Looks kind of neat, doesn't it?
Just goes to show that with a little bit of effort and some elbow grease and slinging a little paint, you can make something plain Jane look extra special, like you spent a lot of time and money and effort putting together a bike like this. So I think all in all, the end result turned out pretty damn good. Until next time we meet, take it easy YouTube, I'll catch you later.
Yeah!
Doesn't mean you get to ride it, dude. Wait till you get a little older.